didn't know what I wanted to do after high school. I mean, I went to college, my brothers had gone to Purdue. I met somebody who talked about artificial knees and hips, and they said, well, you need to be a mechanical engineer. So I switched over to mechanical engineering my sophomore year.
I wanted to be a mechanical engineer because I always liked mechanical things and how things worked and always fascinated me. And if you want to be an engineer in the state of Indiana, you go to Purdue.
So Matt and I both co-opted. So that's part of the reason we were there in the summer. We ran into each other in the hallway then, and I'd say, hey, Matt Lothamer, and he'd say, hey, Anne McLaughlin. We started doing our projects together over the summer, and there's a lot of long, long hours in the computer lab.
She was smart, and she was nice, and she knew how to handle herself with a bunch of guys, and I just always liked that about her.
I can't ever do things the easy way, so even though, you know, everyone around me was telling me, you should be an engineer. I remember I've had teachers tell me that, my mom's told me that.
I put together a little spreadsheet, showed her the numbers, and said, it just doesn't make any sense to not go to Purdue.
She made a spreadsheet. That's a pretty common thing. It's become home. Any doubts that I had about this is where I needed to be have long since dissolved. I've loved every moment of being here. I remember waiting to see the schedules come out, and I said, oh, I have Dr. Krousgrill. And I remember my mom turned and looked at me like, you have who?
Been here since 1980 as a faculty member. 40 years nonstop, and then if you go back 10 years before that, when I began as an undergraduate, that's a total of 50 years. Purdue is only 150 years old, so you can do the math there and say that you randomly pick 1 year out of those 150, it's a 33% chance I was here.
I told you, I said, oh, he's great. Matt and I both just loved him. He was really good. And
when he teaches something, it just makes sense. He writes it on the screen, and you're like, oh, yeah, I get that.
I have to completely agree with my parents. By far, in a way, this is my most organized online class that I have. It was a family thing. Like, I wanted to have the same the same person as my parents for the one ME class that I take.
From a very young age, her first phrase was like, my do.
We tease her about that because every time I'd say, Emily, you could just do it like this. Nope, my do. I'm going to do it my way. And everything she's ever done, she has to do it her way. But it served her well because Emily's incredibly good at solving problems. She thinks outside the box. That's like an understatement.
My dad is one of the most hardworking and honest people that I have ever met in my life. He tells everything exactly how it is. He's a mechanical engineer to heart. And my mom, just her perseverance through her whole path, it's very inspiring to me to know that I can be a woman and I can have a career and be a strong and independent person like that. So I admire both my parents a lot.
When you graduate from ME at Purdue, that training I think was more rigorous than anything else I've done. And when you can get through that, you can do anything you want to do if you put your mind to it.